Welcome to 24 days of presentation accessibility tips, where I go over a tiny little tip for you every day for the next 24 days. But it'll end in a really cool freebie for you. And throughout all 24 of these tips, you get to put up with my dog whining to go out and play, just like me. Tip number one, the accessibility checker in PowerPoint. Now, you might be using PowerPoint a lot to make your own presentations or presentations for someone else. And the people in the audience, of course, might have issues being able to read some things because of color, or they might need captions for certain things. And the quickest way to find all of the issues or most of the issues within PowerPoint is to use the accessibility checker. Now, just quick caveat, automated checkers rarely catch everything. So you need to use your human brain to go in and double check everything, but this is an excellent place to start. So in Windows version of PowerPoint, which I find amusing that this whole entire window is semi-transparent, but that's okay. That's we're not gonna worry about that. Anyway, the accessibility checker is really easy to use. You can see it in the status bar along the bottom, and it says accessibility. If everything's golden, it'll tell you. Otherwise, it'll say you have some things that you might want to look at. It'll say investigate. So how do we pull up the accessibility checker? Well, there are a couple ways, but the fastest way is to just click on that accessibility thing in the status at the bottom. And that opens up this great little panel on the side. What's even cooler is that for some of you who are on newer versions or insider previews of Microsoft Office apps, you might already have, it might even be released to the public, I don't know, but there's a new accessibility tab in the ribbon. It's contextual, so if you click on the accessibility thing down here, the tab magically shows up. But let's look at the panel over on that side. And what it's telling me here is that I have a whole ton of errors because I, fun fact, made this for myself. I wasn't gonna distribute it to anybody, so I didn't do what I do for everybody else's presentations. So we've got errors. We've got 165 missing alternative texts. And if I open that up, it'll show me every single thing in my presentation that does not have alt text. And oh my God, how are you supposed to find all of that? Well, what's really, really handy is if you click on something in this accessibility tab, it will automatically take you to the slide that that object is on, and it will select that object. So I can immediately address the problem. But in this accessibility ribbon, pane over here, it gives you the inspection results. Below it, you can either check or uncheck to have the accessibility checker running constantly while you work. If you're familiar with InDesign, it's like the live pre-flight that's at the bottom of your working window. And then they even give you some handy additional information. Like why? Why should you bother fixing it? Why should you bother having alt text? How do you fix it? Ooh, I almost threw my mouse on the floor. That would have been fun for you. Okay, and then they, you know, give you extra links to show you just for more information. So I've got a lot of missing alt text, and guess what? That's another day. So stick around for all 24 days, and I'll even tell you about alt text and well, everything that shows up in this accessibility checker, quite frankly. Also, let's see, I have a table with no headers. I have four tables with no header rows in this presentation. Why are header rows important? You guessed it. I will tell you on another day. But if I click on these, you'll see that I have several tables that just, they don't have header rows. What else does it check for? Missing slide titles. Now, this one I will give you the remedy for. There might be some instances in which you don't want to have a title on your screen. You might not want to see it at all. See the behind the scenes of my thing. So this one, I don't have a slide title. It's part of an animation sequence, and I just don't want it there. But if I were to be handing this out, it would be great for accessibility purposes, for screen readers, et cetera, to have those titles. It's to help people with cognitive issues and all kinds of other things. And yeah, I'm rambling, but let me show you a really quick trick. I don't like that slide. Let's go to this slide. So this slide doesn't actually have a title on it like the rest of these do. So what do I do? I go to home, let's see. What layout did I use? I used a blank layout. So what if I change it to a title only layout? That's gonna automatically put this placeholder for a title, but it's empty, so it's still yelling at me right here that I don't have one. Color come from brand. Okay, I just added a title, but I don't want it on my slide. So how do I maintain slide accessibility? Our presentation accessibility, I slide this right on off of here. And you know what? How does that affect a PDF later? Well, stick around and we'll find out. But not today. Anyway, missing slide titles. Let's see, warnings. Ooh, use captions for audio and video. I have a video here, but I don't have captions on it. Hard to read text contrast. This is one of my favorites. I don't actually know if that's really one of my favorites. I don't know why I said that, but there are lots of them. So let's just select this guy right here. We'll talk about color contrast later, but it's going to tell me if this text color and the color it is sitting on has too low of a contrast. So people with visual impairments might not be able to read it. So maybe you should fix that. What else does the accessibility checker check for? Reading order, which is incredibly important. When you go through a screen reader, you don't want the slide to be read backwards or in some rando order. So this one is alerting you that this might not actually be how you want it. And maybe, just maybe, you should check it out. And then, oh, look, it gives me tips. So these aren't warnings, but these are just things like, hey, you have more than one slide that has the same title. And that's because I have a morph animation going between two slides. And I want the same title there, but you know, things just change and animate between them. So it's just giving me tips saying, hey, you might want to check it out. I don't know if this is what you intended, but it's trying to be super helpful. And then intelligent services. This is new. I'm seeing this, I think, for the first time. So what's it do? I don't know. Let's find out. Okay, slide 16 right here. This thing doesn't have alternative text. So is it suggesting? What is this? Verified. Ooh, it has a drop down next to it. It's gonna try and recommend some alt text for me. Let's see what it's going to choose. Graphical user interface application description automatically generated. Well, that's a really crappy piece of alt text. And yeah, so since this is part of my animation and it disappears in the important part, stick around, I would actually mark that as decorative and ignore what they gave me. I would highly recommend you don't use this generate a description for me button. AI is getting better, but it's not quite there yet. Anyway, let's go back to the accessibility checker. And yeah, that is That is what the accessibility checker is checking or telling me. Ooh, wait, you guys, there's a button. Oh, okay, that's the alt text button there. Things they are changing. But other ways you can get to accessibility checker is if you go to the review ribbon, you can click on check accessibility there as well, and it will take you to, well, it'll take you to this ribbon. But how about this? What does it look like on a Mac? Well, let me pull up my Mac version. So this is Mac version of PowerPoint. Has the same accessibility checker, notice in the bottom. I can keep accessibility checker running here just like I could before. Oh, the intelligent services show up here as well. And let's see. I don't get, oh, okay. So unlike on PC, I don't have an option to just automatically click a thing and be taken to review the alt text like I did over on the PC side. I can't right click on it. There's no drop down arrow. So I'm going to have to right click on the object itself and choose edit alt text from that menu to get to the alt text to review it. So that's a bummer. I like that little feature in PC land. What else? Let's see. If we go to the review ribbon in Mac side, there's also a check accessibility button here. If I click on that, that opens and closes the accessibility tab, the accessibility pane on the right, but I don't get an accessibility ribbon on the Mac, and I can't remember if that's because it doesn't exist in the Mac yet or if I just haven't updated the Mac side. I don't know, maybe I'll tell you later in these 24 days. So that's it. That's really a quick overview of the accessibility checker, what it shows you that you need to do, and a little way to, to navigate it and use it. Happy day one of 24 days of presentation accessibility tips. I hope you come back in the next day to see what tomorrow brings. I don't even know what tomorrow brings. We'll just find out. Thanks for stopping by. Oh, and hey, just maybe consider liking and subscribing to the channel. Thanks for stopping by. Happy day one. See you next time.